Hello, I'm Karma Kitaj, and I'm your host for A Livelihood, New Adventures as We Age. Today I'm going to introduce you to Archie Stewart, and we are actually in his studio in Alston, Mass. And if you look around a little bit, which you'll get to do soon, you'll see that he is a kite maker and educator and performer.
Thank you.
Archie, hello.
It's good to be. I'm glad you were able to come. I need to ask you a couple of questions. Do you fly kites?
Well, I think I mentioned to you, I probably have not flown a kite since I was 7 or 8. Oh. I can't remember. Although that's probably not
true, okay.
Because I do remember going to like Franklin Field in Boston.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Maybe when my son was little.
That is one of the oldest kite festivals in the country, actually.
Is that?
That's correct.
I didn't
yeah.
know that.
And I used to make kites for the kids in the late 80s, early 90s on Kite Day.
Mm-hmm.
I normally ask anyone that I'm in the classroom with, do they run with a kite? And do you remember running with your kite?
I can't really remember anything I did with the kite.
It's okay.
But you're not supposed to run, I think, right?
There's no need to run. Mm-hmm. I tell the kids you don't need to run. And I ask them, why do you run? And they say, oh, I got to get the air.
Uh-huh.
I have a saying that if the wind is in your face, you're in the wrong place. So if you have the wind to your back, it'll push the kite away from you.
Mm.
And if the wind is blowing at 5 miles an hour, and if you walk backwards 5 miles an hour, actually the wind is hitting the kite at 10 miles an hour. So
okay.
It's important that the kids or anyone who's flying a kite understands their environment.
Is that always so easy to do, though, on a day that's not very windy?
On a day that's not very windy, you look around for signs.
Trees moving or
trees
something.
Trees moving. Smoke coming out of a chimney. You can pick up grass, and you can drop it.
Okay. So let's start earlier on, though. And I know you told me you worked for what used to be called 9X, which is
9X is now Verizon.
I was
a manager at a downtown office in Government Center, and then at the office on Belvedere Street where they just had the fire at the Sheridan.
Okay. We're talking about Boston.
This is downtown Boston, that's mm-hmm. correct. And in 82, my brother gave me a kite.
Uh-huh.
And the job I had was very stressful.
Mm.
So he gives me this kite, and he says, oh man, this is really cool. And I looked at him like he had two heads.
Mm-hmm.
He has since said he created a monster. But that kite, I used to go out during lunch over to Magazine Field in Cambridge by the water,
mm-hmm.
and I learned to fly that kite.
And then you did take early retirement,
I guess,
from your job.
I did. They offered me an early retirement, and I said, thank you very much. And they said, what? You're going to take? I said, yes. So I started doing little programs with kids. And I did after-school programs building kites, and I kind of studied up on the history of kites, where they came from, and I found myself taking kids on a tour around the world where kites began 200 BC. I want to make learning fun for the kids, and I call it stealth learning. I'll teach
Stealth
learning, mm-hmm. exactly. And I'll teach the kids a little history, mm-hmm. geography, social mm-hmm. studies, and math projects.
Yeah, so they don't even realize.
And they don't realize they're learning.
Well, it sounds like your life has changed dramatically.
It has.
Since you discovered kites. And who would have known? Right? You never.
I feel blessed.
You never expected that when your brother gave you that first.
No, I didn't. No, I didn't.
So you know what? Maybe we should take a little tour around your wonderful studio here and look at a few of these kites, and you can tell us something about the origin and maybe how you even make some of these kites.
All right, I'll do that.
One of my favorite kites is called a rokaku. It's Japanese. Roka meaning six. Kaku is a kite. So it's a six-sided kite. And it's one of my favorites because I can use the kite, the face of the kite, as a palette to put whatever design I want to.
So what else do we have in this studio?
We have what's called an eddy kite. It's developed by, most people call it a diamond kite. This is one of the kites that I use in my workshops with the kids. Mm-hmm. We make a smaller version of it.
Sometimes fly kites that have more than one line.
Got a minute? I'll set it up real quick.
Okay. Should I just keep flying here all by myself?
All by yourself. I trust you. Come toward me. I'm going to set up what's called a quad line kite. Four-line kite. This is called a Revolution brand kite. It's one of the first four-line kites that were made out of San Diego, California. If I can get you to stand behind the kite and just let it rest on your legs like that. Uh-huh. Just let it rest on your legs. Okay, just leave it. Yep.
Oh, this is all these lines. God.
I'm with you.
Okay, well,
Good.
Archie Stewart, our kite educator.
Thank you so much. You are wonderful.
Thank you. That was great. That was so much fun.